We're gonna grunt. We're gonna sweat. Right? Because that's the longest place, right?
Yeah.
So you don't have anything restricting you in your training, right? Yeah, you're not gonna be worried about anybody. Mm-hmm. We come down here, we kick ass, right?
Yeah, so. Sure.
By my face, hey, don't got time to waste, yeah. I don't need permission, I'ma do it all today, yeah. They just can't believe it, man, that's all they gon' say. See these plays up on my Spotify, that's money in the bank up on my face. Hey, don't got time to waste, yeah. I don't need permission, I'ma do it all today, yeah. They just can't believe it, man, that's all they gon' say. See these plays up on my Spotify, that's money in the bank, yeah. I remember back when they said I won't do a thing. Now, shawty, why you talking, huh? That's why you a flame. Did it by myself. No, I don't need it.
This is Homework Fit Studio. We are a personal training studio. We do one-on-one training. We also do small boot camp classes. I run this place with my girlfriend, Cassandra. She's not here right now, but that's okay. That's pretty much what we specialize in. We have a lot of new clients coming in every week, and it's getting pretty busy now, so book your spot.
Very nice.
Coming up soon. So we started this place, well, we had a soft launch in October. We started building this place back in April. It took a long time, but we did a soft launch in October and a full launch in December, on December 15th. That was kind of our goal, is to open up a space where people can come and feel comfortable. They don't have to go to a commercial gym. Some people get embarrassed about working out in front of other people. We want to make this an inclusive environment. So if you don't really know what you're doing, there's nobody else around down here. When you come for your sessions, it's you and the personal trainer. So you come here, we train you one-on-one, and there's nobody else around, so you can sweat, you can make stupid faces, all that kind of stuff, right? You don't have to worry about anybody judging you, making fun of you. So that's kind of the crowd we're aiming towards, people that are trying to get back into fitness. We can give them the tools to go back to a commercial gym and know what they're doing.
It's Extreme Monkey Squat Rack. All the stuff that we purchase here is from Treadmill Factory in Barrie.
Thanks.
Shout out to you guys. They're really nice to deal with. They helped us a lot, helped us out a whole bunch, answered our questions whenever we needed help. So they kitted us out with all this brand new equipment. They gave us a really good deal on everything. So we tried to maximize the amount of space that we have, so it can get a little tight once in a while. So we're just placing everything where we can have enough space to do all our classes and then have our clients down here.
Mm-hmm.
Most of our stuff is easy to move, like our rower here, even the benches and stuff. So we have a lot of space. If we need it, we can start moving some stuff around. So we're pretty happy with the equipment and the service that we got from Treadmill Factory.
Looks like you got everything you need.
Yeah, so technically, we got most stuff we need. At least all the essentials. We have dumbbells up to 100 pounds. We have our cable machine. We have a deadlift platform. Just some of the essentials. Also, we have a lat pull down attachment at the back of the squat rack. So it's plate loaded, toss the plates on there. We bring the bench over. We can do some lat pull down, some low cable rows, because it's called the infinity rack because there's a bunch of different attachments you can get on it. We got the J hooks on here. We have a landmine attachment down at the bottom.
Oh,
so
nice.
We can do some rows or anything like that. And then the lat pull down attachment. So there's a lot of different things. There's pegs as well for it that you can put the weights onto. So it's a very good rack. Also, we can do some band training. It's got the attachments for the band. So overall, it's a good squat rack. That's a place I would probably start, getting a decent squat rack.
Cool. All right, what are we working on today?
We're going to work on some shoulders today.
Okay. All right, what's this called? What are we doing here?
Behind the back barbell shot.
Behind the back.
It's more like an isolation where you're not using so much your front delts when you're kind of forward. Like you're really kind of, you know, it's putting a strain on your front delts. Like I've had shoulder problems in the past, so I try to avoid as much as like front delt activation if I'm not trying to activate it at all. So I found this one is pretty good. The first couple times I did it, I was like, it's not bad. But then like as I kept doing it, and then the body started to respond to it.
Right.
So you just have to like get used to it, kind of. So
usually start about here, so you can do some racket from here.
Yep.
Oh, it's just gonna make it up above your ass pretty much. But you can use like your elbows.
A little bit of elbow.
It kind of suits like you did back when the day before, because you will feel the stretch in your ass for sure. I've done that, and I'm like, oh shit, what the fuck?
That heavy going on, not too heavy.
Not too heavy, no, because, well, my wrists are kind of garbage after training for 3 or 4 years. Yeah. I started to kind of...
Aches and pains, yeah.
I think a little weak, my fingers like to start to roll out a little bit. So yeah, I stick to like maybe 185, maybe 225 usually.
Okay.
As you're down there, 225. Sure.
Alright.
Yeah, we'll start with just the 45s or whatever and just get a feel for it. And I found too, like you can use whatever grip you want. I tend to just hook my hands, so it's just more a pull. Like you're not like, not using anything else going. So, just
rack it.
It's a slight bend, not too much. And just.
Never seen this one before.
Oh, it's nice.
Yeah, I'm really trying to get that squeeze up here. You can really feel it. You know, mainly when you're doing shrugs, like the, you know, like the most activation, like the most strain you're gonna put on it is the negative. Like you want that pull, or else you're really not working much.
Nice. Even just tricking your body.
Tricking the body. The whole muscle confusion thing.
Alright, Rich Piano taught me that.
Yeah.
There we go. Nice.
Woo.
Good.
Remember to breathe.
Top tip. Breathe.
Come, so I'm not breathing there. I get a fucking hernia. There you go. There you go. I'll stay here. I like this room. This one.
How many reps? How many sets?
I say four reps. Or sorry, four sets. Try to stay between 8 to 10 reps.
Yeah.
I wouldn't go any further than that, really. Because it is more of like for a bit of power, right? Like you want it to be heavy, so it puts a lot of strain on there. You know, it tears the fascia and all that stuff, so it can rebuild and get bigger, because you want to look froggy.
Swole is the goal size.
Swole is the goal.
Swole is the goal.
Swole
is the goal size press. So it's kind of like a behind the back row.
Pretty much, yeah. Yeah, that's a good way to look at it.
Like also, when you train our clients here, I don't really, we have cardio machines, but I don't make them do too much cardio because it's kind of a waste of time. Well, obviously cardio is not a waste of time.
No, that's
true. But when they're coming here, like they're here to train, anybody can go ride a bike or do a rower, right? So we focus mainly on just weight training. Like I'll warm them up on here. Cassie does a little bit more in their HIIT training classes.
Yep.
But for when I train people, we do a little bit of endurance and interval training, but we don't go over the top with cardio because we're here to lift some weights, right? So,
and that, you know, they always say, though, the harder you train, the more you do cardio.
Yeah, exactly, right? Yeah. There's a new study that you came out.
Yeah.
I think a couple months ago that showed that
high intensity
resistance and weight training is actually better for losing weight than doing cardio training. Obviously, cardio training is important to put
more
into your...
For the cardiovascular, like capacity and stuff.
But building muscle promotes fat loss, right? And weight loss, so we try and stick with the weight training here a little bit.
Yep.
He's got a
warm up or whatever, but I usually do it for a finish or something. Like the far raise and then the side raise.
Yeah.